Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. It's 7 o'clock-ish in the morning, give or take. We've had breakfast, we've had a drink, we're packing up, and we are leaving to go somewhere else. Don't really know where yet, just somewhere else. That is a polar bear. I feel like I ought to avoid the polar bear. I may not have a choice. Oh dear. Arctic bear. Gonna be an Arctic bear. There is no Arctic. So why don't I install some mods like... Oh god. Mart's monster mod wasn't so bad. Oh right, okay, here's where we die. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh god. Confuse it on the rocks. There we go. That's what I wanted to see. Some mods, like, Mars Monster Mod wasn't so bad, that's what I was saying. Oh god! That was unpleasant. I think it was Oblivion Warcry. I think that's what the mod was called, but I'm trying to remember. I don't know, my bow is glitching out and, I hate bears. Have I ever mentioned that? Great. Well, now you get to watch me do all the breakfast eating crap again, I suppose. Well, you get to watch me do it for the first time, because you missed it last time, because I cut it out of the recording because it was needless busy work. Which now will be featured prominently because of a bear, basically. Fucking Christ. Bears. Anyway, there was this mod called Oblivion Warcry, and it came as part of FCOM, and it's one of the reasons I never installed FCOM, ever. It was because it came with a bunch of stupid monsters and creatures, like Beholders from Dungeons & Dragons, and those little demon thingies from Diablo. It just randomly shoved them into Oblivion, and with no explanation. They were just, hey, yeah, these things that were in Diablo, they're in this game now. Why am I carrying these? I don't need them. They can go. Got this Wethel shield. That's the Ice Dragon Clan insignia, which I was keeping because it's worth 90 gold, but... Anyway. Well, one of the things it added was a Welsh rabbit. A Welsh rabbit. I mean, think about that for a second. There is no Wales in Tamriel, so how can a Welsh rabbit exist? but you know, just dumb things like that. Oops. Well, mead'll do then, I suppose. Whoops. Right, yeah, we'll leave all this here. We'll pack this up. Mother of Christ, right. I need to turn my headset volume down because it's actually kind of loud. That's better. Don't want to get deafened every time I cast a spell. Now then. Yeah, avoid Mr. Bear this time. Head somewhere else instead. Oh, sucks being low level in Elder Scrolls games, it really does. It's one of the nice things about playing Skyrim, honestly. I mean, people say to me, oh, Skyrim, Claudius is so OP, he destroyed Mirak. And the thing is, guys, I don't care. It's nice in one of my Let's Plays to actually be able to kill things quite easily without having to worry about it too much. It's rather nice. Because when I play this game, I'm getting killed to death by bears. Who I'm having to exploit the dodgy AI with just to have a fighting chance. Or if it's in Morrowind, I'm getting one-hitted by guys with Warhammers. So, yeah, I think I can just about deal with, you know, completely ruffle stomping all over Mirak in Skyrim. But anyway, that's a different Let's Play. Why am I talking about it here? That's very unprofessional of me. More than, you know, average. Anyway, unprofessionalism is what I do, after all, but... We're going southwest now, I've decided. By pure virtue of the fact that there aren't any bears over here. We're going southwest. Which will eventually probably take us somewhere like Coral, I'm not sure. If it does, then so be it. I don't really mind. I could do with a good dungeon or to go through, but honestly, actually, having dealt with that bear just now, a dungeon would probably just send my frustration levels through the roof. A nice easy dungeon, maybe a cave or something, even though caves are a bit dull.
I'll tell you what's dull though,
wilderness. Like this, with nothing in it. Okay, game, you win. There's nothing here to see. Move along. I'm moving south now. Please give me something interesting to work with here. I'm in the wrong neck of the woods for interesting stuff, though, really. I should be going east. That's where all the cool stuff is. Nice music though. It's from the original Medieval Total War. I think it played on the campaign map during a certain season. But I always liked it, I thought it was quite good. Fits very well for wilderness exploring, especially in Oblivion, I find. If you can even hear it, I don't know, it might be one of those days where the music's really quiet. Unfortunately, Oblivion has this really annoying habit at the minute of completely resetting all my options every time I start the game. It does that thing where you open the launcher and it just goes, Oblivion is now detecting your hardware, blah blah blah, and then just redoes all my options, and I'm like, oh god. Aha, a fort. Just what I was looking for. Zog has come to Cyrodiil to find treasure. Not to camp in woods and eat boar meat. As much as Zog likes to camp in woods and eat boar meat, it is not his purpose. Here in this province, he can do that back in Orsinium as much as he damn well pleases. Steep inclines, though. You could climb that if you got on all fours. Blast and damn it. I guess that was one of the nice things about Daggerfall. You could climb in that game. Like you could climb over the city walls if you wanted to, if you arrived at night and the gates were locked and shut. Instead, I have to do this nonsense, right? I'm walking diagonally up the thing, trying to find a way up there. There we go. There is always a thing, like when Skyrim was coming out and Todd Howard was sat there like, oh, that's the great thing about Elder Scrolls games, you see those mountains over there? You could go climb them. And then a friend of mine said, well, actually, Todd Howard, what's going to happen is you're going to be running awkwardly, diagonally up those mountains trying to find a way up them. And come on, you've got to admit he's right. Let's see. Oh, come on. I'm so close. And yet so far. No, there really isn't a way up here, is there? Maybe if I go diagonally this way for a bit. Perhaps. Maybe. God, the terrain is a bit weird, isn't it? I don't think they bothered smoothing it out, did they? Now, if I shimmy along to this side again. Come on, I'm so close. There's like a slightly shallower bit here that surely I can walk on. Surely. Come on. There we go. Yes. Excellent. Right. I've conquered the mountain. Through sheer perseverance and the auto-run key. What do we got? And a pile of junk. That's what we have for our efforts, ladies and gentlemen. A pile of junk and a brazier with some planks in it. Ooh, and a statue. Ooh, and some coffin things. Which we can't get into, but they're there. nonetheless. And there's coral down there. Uh-huh. Right. Oh, gosh, I think I know where this leads. Okay, no, maybe that's further down. In this general locale, though, is where that epic ruin, that alien one was, where in the Idris LP we went there, and then it basically just set us up for the rest of the series because we got so much cool loot from that place. Oh, yeah, no, I've been here before. Probably not in a Let's Play, but I've been here before. This little promontory here. I remember it quite vividly. Yeah. If you want trackless bloody wilderness with trees and mountains and stuff, you really can't beat Oblivion. It's quite impressive in that regard. I mean, people obviously criticise, and myself included in that, really. Criticise Oblivion for being just very, very boring generic fantasy in so many ways. And yet, in some ways, I feel it's also its strength of its. You know? Sometimes I just want to go through generic fantasy woodland and fight generic fantasy enemies in generic fantasy ruins. You know, sometimes I'm just in the mood for that. Is there even a way into this place? It's not like there is. I think it's just a tower with no entrance. Or if it had one, it's collapsed or something. Hmm. Well, it's just eye candy then. I can't do anything. Excuse me, do anything with it. Yeah, well. Does it have a slate roof on it? That bit there. Looks like it does, you know. Just seems oddly out of place. Hello there, Mr. Person. Don't know who you are. Someone in the comments will. Oh, I've gone and said it now. Someone in the comments will know. Which means that all the comments on this video for years to come are just going to be answering that question. Because, for some reason, people just seem completely incapable of just checking the comments section before they've posted to see if anyone else has already mentioned it. You might say, well, Dave, you can't expect us to sort of scroll through the entire comments section just to see if something's been mentioned, but no, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about when someone has literally, about 20 seconds ago, commented, Dave, yeah, the answer to your question was this. And then, literally 20 seconds later, someone else will say the exact same thing. Like, the newest comment in the pile underneath the video will be, well, you know, anyway, you get what I mean. It just never ceases to boggle my mind how unobservant people can actually be. I guess we're going down here towards coral. It just seems the game seems to be inexorably leading me towards that place. Inexorably. I like that word. I don't know. I think I feel like I've said that more than once lately. Inexorably. I can't remember where, but I... Ooh! Treasure chest! With 7 gold in it. Charming. And pillar. I think I know what that is. Zog doesn't know, so we'll move on. I don't know, all the comments are going to be at that as well, aren't they now? Oh, God. I'm on a roll today. what is that? It's a wolf! I can take a wolf. In fact, I'd quite like to, on account of the fact that... Can we just please get rid of that arrow bug? That's very annoying. That's better. Duke Patrick's sodding archery mod that's responsible for that bug. I'm quite sure of it. Oh, yay, now I'm dead. It was a giant wolf, not a regular one. Good God. Where was this quick save? Where was it? In some woods somewhere. Oh, it was here. Okay, well. We can skip the sightseeing this time and just head straight down the mountain. Just save a bit of time. Yeah. I was saying something and now I've forgotten. But never mind. Give me them. Give me those. Hello, that looks like steps. I reckon we can climb up that. Somehow. Is that maybe a ladder on the side of it? Ooh, okay, now I'm intrigued. We've definitely taken a different turning here somewhere because I don't remember this. Oh, there you go. I would never have seen this if I hadn't reloaded the game. So thank you, Giant Wolf. Now where's your little brother who's just run off down here? There you are. A young wolf. I require your meat. Now then. Time to investigate Hammerfell Pass. Really? We're that far west? It would appear so. Hammerfell Pass, right here. That's Hammerfell all the way out. I mean. Every time I go around a corner here, I'm expected to just come face to face with a giant or something. It just strikes me as the kind of territory giants would live in. So this is what I love about the unique landscapes. It just adds stuff. You know, it's not necessarily stuff you can do anything with. It's not necessarily a dungeon you can explore. It's just things that you can find, like this old abandoned ruin, and you look at it and you think, I wonder what it was once upon a time when it wasn't a ruin. And that up there. Obviously, this is some kind of big network of fortifications along here between Cyrodiil and Hammerfell. And we're just sort of wandering through the crumbling remains of it, which, you know, God knows how long it's been since someone's been here, you know? That's the remnants, obviously, of some sort of avalanche where the rock has just fallen away and there's, like, bits of, you know, tree logs and rocks everywhere. And it's great. It's great. It doesn't fit into any particular category. It doesn't fit into, oh, this is a fort ruin, this is a cave, this is an alien ruin. It just is what it is. And that's something that Morrowind was very good at. Yes, I'm going on about Morrowind again. Deal with it, you fucking retards. I like that game. Is this news to you or what? but that's something Morrowind, yeah, did very well. And it's something that Unique Landscapes put into Oblivion. And it's something I feel Skyrim occasionally falls prey to. I mean, it has nice stuff in it. Don't get me wrong, it's definitely much better design than vanilla Oblivion was, but everything in that game has to serve some sort of purpose from a gameplay perspective. It has to fit into some neat map marker category. Whereas, obviously in Oblivion, I mean Morrowind, that was never the case, because Morrowind just didn't have map markers in that sense or anything. Nothing fit into categories. I mean, obviously you had things like Daedric Ruins and Caves, but they were all, you know, quite unique, actually. Especially when it came to caves, I've noticed. Caves are always generally rather interesting in Morrowind, and yet in Oblivion they're boring as fuck. So yeah, this takes us up, yeah, that's what I figured. It's just sort of a watchtower of some description. Very cool. And there's coral all the way down there. Might go pay the place a visit, sell some of our stuff. Ladder? Oh, you... Alright, okay, I was clicking on the wrong part of the ladder. What the bloody hell? There's Conan music and a thing. It's a Minotaur, right. I did say giants earlier, I guess I wasn't far off. This is good Minotaur battling music, though. Let's be honest. Ooh. Let's be very careful here not to fall off. I don't want to... He may not be that tough, but I'm not taking a chance. Right, de-knocking arrows. That brings me on to another subject. Apparently, wrong button. Apparently, I can do that, actually. I don't have to install a separate mod. It's already in the game as part of one of the patches I've got. So that's kind of cool. D-knock! Oh my god. This allows you to D-knock an arrow if you decide to not to shoot it. Can set to any key or... Oh god, I have to set it to a... that's irritating. Maybe I'll set it to one of my mouse buttons. Enable. No, I don't want to set it to the grab button. Good grief. Press the key of the control you want mapped as option. Invalid choice? On your bike? Does it have... Really? It has to be a keyboard key. I can't use one of my thumb buttons on my mouse. That sucks. That's shit. That's really shit. All the handy ones are all being used by something. X, maybe? Invalid choice. E is obviously use stuff. Q is cast magic. C is auto run. Ugh. Z is grab. Z's kind of awkward to get to, though, really, in the middle of a fight. R is sheath weapon. Maybe that'll work. Maybe that'll... Let's try that. It let me do it, so... Ah, would you look at that? There we go. See, now it's bugged out my animation, though, hasn't it? Look. Oops. Forgetting my keyboard shortcuts here. Okay, it seems to be alright. Alright, okay, cool. Alright, fine. Thank you for those. Thank you for the mandrake roots. Make a lot of cure disease potions with those. And we're probably going to need them too. This is our young wolf friend. Where does this go then? It's very sort of rough looking, not terribly well smooth terrain here. I feel like this is how we know we're getting off the map. You, oh no! Come back here. Cannot escape me that easily. I will gladly take falling damage for a large wolf pelt, fuck's sake. Yes, welcome. So let's play Oblivion. The trials and tribulations of a barbarian stuck in a civilized province. I do like Zog though. I think he's fun. Unfortunately, the game he's in right now, yeah, it leaves a lot to be desired sometimes. In many ways, I feel like he's the opposite of Claudius. Claudius was a civilized fellow going into a very uncivilized land, whereas Zog is a very uncivilized fellow going into a very civilized land. It presents its own unique and interesting problems. Yeah, I can't... Those almost look like they should be harvestable. They really do. Oh god, something's not bugged out, has it? I need to find something I can activate now, just to make sure. You there! Okay, no. Right. Weird. Right. Yes, once again, we are being inexorably led down the mountain. What can I say? I like the word. I think inexorably is a very nice word. I'll tell you what my favourite word, though, is. Empurpled. Yeah, that's an actual word, believe it or not. Empurpled. Good sir, you have become empurpled, he said as the man's face turned a brilliant shade of violet. Empurpled, yeah, fantastic word. A bit like bungalow, that's an awesome word as well. Wonder who that fellow is then. Not the horse, I mean him. Who is that then, I wonder, he said, pointing at the horse's arse. Oh god. I did that! Jesus Christ. Have you mentioned that the weird way that you sort of run off into in a very sort of Looney Tunes-esque fashion in this game. You run straight off the side of things and then fall down. It can't help but remind me of Wile E. Coyote just running off the edge of a canyon and then realizing he's run off the edge of the canyon and then falling down a couple of seconds later. Sort of what it feels like in this game, really. Especially when you're trying to run down stairs or something. I mean, I can't remember whether or not we saw it earlier, but I think it was vaguely... Okay, this looks interesting. I recall a wolf managing to kill itself just by running off a steep bit of hill. Falling to its death. Okay, we're in some sort of gorge, ravine type. This is awesome. This is really cool. Kind of reminds me a bit of The Witcher 2. The gullies in The Witcher 2. With all the harpies and stuff. Hopefully we won't find any harpies, though. Oh, I had to say it, didn't I? Yeah. Oh, it's a giant wolf again. Wonderful. God. Oh, good heavens. Get stuck on terrain. Yeah, running backwards through a gully is probably not the most sensible course of action ever devised by... Well, let's face it, a very desperate orc. You're like a bear in wolf form, I don't like you. You did a lot of damage to me earlier. Oh shit, now we're in trouble. Oof. Blimey. Come on, one more. One more! God! One more! Whew! Yeah, we need to increase our marksman skill. Just a tad. 3 wolf meat, though. I mean, that's not to be sniffed at. That's, you know, that's pretty good. Where's my alchemy stuff? Cannibalettes and wolf meat. Hey presto, 8 health potions. Not bad. I think we're a little hungry, though, because my health bar's down slightly. Slightly hungry and slightly thirsty, right? Okay. Let's deal with the hunger and worry about the thirst later. Mutton! So... Where are we now? Oh, yes, no, I do recognize this now. Yeah, this is, we came here with Idris a long time ago. I remember fighting something around here somewhere and then summoning a scamp to kill it for me. And the scamp didn't do a very good job, from what I remember. Cloud top. Okay, we got in a big bloody circle then, basically. Oh, no, we haven't. No, technically we haven't, because I don't think... Yeah, there we go. So we haven't been here yet. We know, with this save. Right, so... On reflection, though I'm still glad the giant wolf killed me, because we had a much more interesting trip having gone the scenic route.